So that's kind of just the motivation for the simulated annealing algorithm, but there's an actual algorithm, and it's remarkably simple and remarkably effective. So the algorithm goes like this. We're just going to repeat for some finite set of iterations. We're going to be at some point x, and we're going to sample a new point, x of t, from the neighborhood of x. And then what are we going to do? Well, we're going to move our x to that xt probabilistically. So in particular, we've got this probability function, pxxtt, which is going to help us decide whether or not to actually make the move. And the form of that function is written out here. So the probability that if we're currently at x, and we're thinking about moving to x sub t, little t, and the current temperature is capital T, then what's going to happen? If the fitness of the new point is bigger than or equal to the old point, we're just going to make the move. All right, so we always hill climb when we are at a point where we can do that.
So that's just regular old hill climbing.
It's kind of like hill climbing, exactly. It's a little different from the hill climbing the way we described it, where we said, let's visit all the points in the neighborhood. This is kind of a useful thing to be able to do when the neighborhood's really large, is just choose anything in the neighborhood, and if it's an improvement, go for it.
Okay.
But what if it's not an improvement? Well, if it's not an improvement, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the fitness difference between the point that we're evaluating and the point where we are now, look at the difference between those two, divide that by the temperature, take e to that, and interpret that as a probability. And we either make the move or not with that probability. So, all right, so we got to dive in a little bit to this expression to make some sense out of it. So, what happens, Charles, if the point that we currently visited x, then we visit a neighbor point xt. What if their fitnesses are really close to each other? Say, just infinitesimally close to each other.
Well, if they're infinitesimally close to one another, then that means that difference is going to be very close to zero.
Right. And so we get zero over, it doesn't matter what the temperature is, we get zero. E to the zero is one, so we make the move if it's infinitesimally smaller than where we were now. All right, what if it's a big step down?
Well, then that means that number is really, really negative.
Yes.
And then negative divided by some positive number. T is a temperature, so T is always greater than or equal to zero.
Yeah, let's say that.
Okay.
In
So it's
fact, probably making it equal to zero could run us into trouble. So let's just say that it's bigger
So it's Kelvin. So it's in Kelvin. Okay, so
than zero.
that'd be a really, really big negative number, and e to a really big negative number is 1 over e to a really big number, so that makes it very close to zero.
Good. Right. So, in other words, if a giant step down, we probably won't take it.
Right. Okay, that makes sense. So you're sort of smoothly going in directions that kind of look bad as a function of how bad they look and sort of exaggerating that difference through an exponential function. Right? Okay,
Sure,
so
if that gets you going.
well, so 3 isn't 3 times worse than 1. It's, 2 to the 3 times worse than 1.
I see, or e to the, well, so good. But let's look at one more thing with this equation here. Let's say that there's a moderate step down. So it's not so huge that when we divide it by t, it's essentially negative infinity. Let's just say it's a smaller thing, negative 5 or something like that.
Okay.
Then what happens? Now we get some e to the that is going to be some probability between 0 and 1. What does t do in this case? What if t is something really big? What if t is something really small?
Well, if t is something really big, let's say infinity, then it doesn't matter what the difference is. It's effectively going to be zero.
Right, so a really big temperature here means that we're going to have some negative thing divided by something else. This is going to be essentially zero, and it's going to be e to the zero, so it's going to be one. So when the temperature is really high, we're actually willing to take downward steps, and we don't even sort of notice that it's going down.
Right,
There's lots of randomness happening.
so in fact, if T is infinity, it's really, 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 really hot. Then even if the neighbor is much, much worse off, he'll be less worse off than infinity. And so basically, you're always just going to jump to the next person, to the next neighbor, to the next point.
Right. So we're very likely to accept. So it's going to move freely. If t is really small, as t approaches zero, what happens?
Well, let's just take the extreme case. So if t was zero or effectively zero, then that means any difference whatsoever basically becomes infinity.
Right. It gets magnified by this very, very small t. And
Right.
so then it's not going to take any downward steps. It's only going to go uphill. Yeah, so that's kind of the essence of the simulated annealing algorithm. So maybe we can talk about some of its properties.
Okay.